Okay, this is more or less a personal. Had another one of those personal moments of my life, which I just want to share. I'm sure you remember the incident I shared with you before. This girl who I wanted to marry, and the reason that she gave me for rejection was, how can I introduce you to my family? You know, because I had tattoos. And that time I didn't have so many. I just had one at the side, the Mike Tyson one. Saying, how can I introduce you to my family? And then, I don't know, I guess she was in a zone. And then she said that if tomorrow we have a baby, what will society say? What will people think? You know, the typical Indian nonsense. You know, people say, look at his father, a freak, the child's father. The child will be ashamed of you. What values will you teach? You know, stuff like that. She may not have said what values, but she definitely said, like, how will you take the child to school? What will people say? People will laugh. You know, that kind of stuff. And she also said that, I want a husband who I can sing, you know, Christmas carols with the family and spend time with the family. I can't, you know, hold your hand and show you to my family people. What will they say? I mean, that, to be honest, that did hurt me a lot that time. Now, just the residue, the memory is there. But, you know, the funny thing is, the part about that child, you know, when you hold the child, what will society think, or how can that child ever love someone like you? You know, stuff like that. So now when my daughter hugs me and I hold my daughter, somehow those words come back. Today I buy my daughter good things. I'm not, I wouldn't say I'm an ideal father because I'm always busy at work. But my baby, whenever I do spend time, I try to spend some quality time. This, you know, it's more like, I'm not trying to make this video to once again bash her up. I don't know even if she watches it. And neither it is to, you know, trumpet my victory. Oh, see, you know, I did it. Ha ha ha, you know. I am far better off than you. No. It's nothing like that. But rather, the point I'm trying to make here is, see, this girl, she wanted a guy who she could show off to society. Sadiqab. She wanted a guy who she could show off to the world. Feel good about, oh, this is my husband. And she did end up with a guy like that. Okay? She did get a guy who she could show all her family members, see, my husband is very tall, he was very handsome, he was very good looking. Okay, everything, great guns. Sadly, he dumped her for the very reason she dumped me. What happened to her was later on she put on, I don't know, she had thyroid issues or whatever. From being this lovely looking woman, I think she put on double or 2.5 times her fat, you know, and she became really fat. Oh my goodness. When I saw her, I couldn't believe my eyes. She was so fat. It's like you're talking of, you know, imagine a slender figure and then loop, loop, poof, oh, ass was a. So what the fuck happened? You know, and to be honest, I don't know how a person can take that. As it is, you have low self-esteem and you want to feel good about it. And then you get a guy to feel good about it. But then that guy treats you like shit and you lose the very guy who you wanted to feel good about. And then your own physical body, from bad, it becomes worse to even worse. And then obviously the the ugliness that comes from the divorce. You know, it's like this. I'll tell you, whenever someone breaks up with you, if you break up or someone breaks up with you, you shouldn't feel bad about it. Seriously. You should not feel bad about it. Yes, at that point of time, you're sensitive, you're tender, you feel that pain, emotional. We all do. But I'll tell you, as you pass through life, as you go through life, 10 years, 5 years, 10 years, 15 years, and if you continue focusing on yourself to become a better human being, and then when you turn back and look at all those memories, moments, those people, you'll really be glad you never married them. See, I'll tell you, today, honestly, I'm genuinely glad she rejected me. Not to say, ha ha ha, fuck you, you know, I'm better off. No, it wouldn't have worked. Why? Because she is my age, more or less, we are both the same age. And, you know, both of us have our egos, and obviously she would put on the thyroid, this thing, she would put on so much of mass. I don't know what you'll say. What if your this wife puts up there? Well, the thing is, this is more like a relationship where we have chosen to be in love, so we'll make it work. Okay? But I'm talking of a relationship where the person, you know, dumped me for these particular reasons. Because she could not show off in society. Because she could not feel good in front of her friends. Because she thought I was a freak. And holding the child, oh my God, how will you? You know, people sometimes, what values will you teach? You're a monster, you're evil, holding this child, I pity this child. People tend to give those comments, but some people even post comments like, man, I would be fucking scared. I got scared looking at you. Your poor baby must be horrified. For my baby, this is the face of her dad, you know, her papa. The person who she loves, who she can play with. She's so used to my face. There's nothing to feel scared about. Unless, of course, I'm disciplining her. So that there's that feeling of joy, you know. And she looks at me, she plays with my face, and like now I have a beard, she pulls my beard. For my baby girl, she doesn't see a monster. But it's we human beings who, we grow up and we face society and we come to know, this is good, this is bad, this makes you look good, this makes you look bad. So we try to live our lives, trying to keep society happy and feel good that we are in the elite society class kind of shit, you know. I'm honestly glad we never got married. I'm honestly glad we didn't have a life. Sadhika, I'm glad we have moved on with our lives. All these ex-girlfriends of mine, I'm really glad, because I'm in a happier place. I'm not feeling good that her marriage broke, and I had 3 failed marriages before this. Okay, I genuinely hope she finds, but it's going to be very hard, because for a female, see, this is the reality. People feel very upset and, oh, you are sexist and all. For a man, he can, even if he's 60, he can still get a girl in her 20s. Okay. And he need not be super rich, just average. But for a lady, very hard to get a young man or even a partner, you know. Because men are visual. They'll judge you based on your looks, your figure. It's an unfortunate thing. We are visual. That's why porn, YouTube, majority are men. We like to see. Women like to feel. That's why 50 Shades of Grey, they would like to read, you know. Men don't like to read. They like to watch. That's why most of the girls feel porn is fake, which is true, because the feeling is manufactured, it's fake. But for a man, he's visually looking at it, he'll be turned on. So that is why, you know, whenever I hold my baby girl now, just brings back those memories where this girl said, how will she, if you have a baby tomorrow, How will she even hold your hand, and how will you even be able to take her to school, and what will people say, what will society say? Today I hold my baby's hand. Society doesn't say anything. I am with my baby. My baby is not afraid. I'd like to believe I'm not a bad father. I wouldn't say I'm a very good father. I'm good enough. It's, I think, we human beings, we like to complicate our own lives sometimes. And I'll tell you, if you have broken up with a girl or a girl broken up with you for all these bullshit reasons, I couldn't marry you because what society will say, what my mother, father will say, what the world will say, how will I do that? Just at that point, it'll seem very hard. But be absolutely overjoyed because you got rid of a curse, man. Women, their body deteriorates with time faster than a man. They face much more challenges than a man. For a man, it's unfair, but this is how life is. I wouldn't want to be a woman, like I told you before. It's too tough a life, man. From the biological disadvantage to the disadvantage in corporate world to the rules of society has put, you know. It's tough for a woman. Anyway, just thought I'd share this with you. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. It's me signing off. Chal, man.